everyone. Welcome to our channel, Biology for All. In this video, I'm going to talk about the villi and the microvilli. The villi and the microvilli are part of the small intestine. So let's first see here the transverse section of the small intestine. This transverse section of small intestine shows the presence of folds in its inner membrane. So these are the folds that are shown in the inner membrane. Now if we enlarge one of the fold, that looks like this. So this black part which I am drawing here is the columnar epithelium, which are in the form of projections. So these projections of this one fold or extensions of the columnar epithelium are called as villi. Now if we take a enlarged part of this villus is the singular of villi. So inside that there are blood vessels and lacteals, and outside we can see the columnar epithelial cells. So these are the columnar epithelial cells. So this is one villus. Now from that, if we take out one cell and see the cell, then we can see extensions of the cell membrane of that particular cell, and those are called as microvilli. Now let us see the structure of one villus. So we begin by drawing the line here to represent the columnar epithelial cells. So that is the basement membrane, and on that the cells are placed. Once we finish drawing this row of cells, that is this columnar epithelial cells, then we are going to draw the inner parts of that. So inside we will be drawing a lacteal and the blood capillaries. So with this we have completed the diagram. Now let us start labeling the parts. So here this is the epithelial cells, and these epithelial cells show the presence of microvilli as seen previously. So this is one layer or single layer of epithelium that facilitates easy diffusion of substances. Now next to that, inside will be the blood capillaries. So there is a network of blood capillaries, and these are placed close to the epithelial cells so that whatever is absorbed is passed into the blood capillaries directly. Inner to that we have the lacteal. Lacteals are lymph vessels which help in absorption of fats. So the blood flows and moves out with a nutrient rich blood. That means the capillaries that are flowing inside, they absorb the nutrients and then they come up with the nutrient rich blood. And this is the lymph vessels.